There's one right there, I think. I'll see if I can catch him. There he is. He's about 30 feet off the bottom.
Got him. There he is.
All they were trout, probably littler guys.
Whoa.
All right, guys, as you just saw there, using the 2D imaging to locate these lake trout, we saw him on the bottom, and then he ran up and smoked me. I had to yo-yo him a little bit. He wanted to chase me down, and then when I got him turned the other way, he just smashed it. That's a Crush City freeloader in albino shad. I kind of like that color. Looks like a smelt Cisco. That's what they're feeding on, and he smashed it. It's a beauty little lake trout. There we go. Nice fish. That's what we're doing. Sharp shooting lake trout. Drive around till you mark them on the screen. Drop down right on top of them and then play around with them. They're very interactive. It's just like ice fishing. You see them on the sonar. You'll see them rush up, smack it. And we will let this guy go. Sharpshooting lake trout is pretty simple. We're using minnow type baits, spinning reels, heavier spinning setups, but more so just the line. We're running like 12-pound test, 12 to 14-pound, a minnow bait, and we're using two-dimensional sonar, 2D sonar. It's traditional sonar imaging, and that's all you really need to do this kind of fishing. We have the live running. We're not really using it, actually. Everything's showing up on 2D, so if you want to run 2D, it's all you need. The kind of the process, though, is we're just looking, and we're just literally looking at the 2D, motoring around the lake until we mark a fish. And you know when you mark a lake trout. It's a large mark, typically up off the bottom. It's easy to get fooled when you're doing this kind of thing. You want to drop your bait down and fish every little mark, but it pays to just have a little bit of patience and wait out until you actually see something fairly significant that you know is a lake trout. The other interesting thing about doing it this way is when you do mark fish, especially suspended, they're more likely to eat.
Got it.
Nice. No.
Ooh, knuckle.
Oh, probably burped. This is a good fish. Pressure her a bit just so we don't
right
wear
here.
Her out.
Nice one.
Beauty. That's awesome.
There we go.
Oh, you know what's so cool? She's actually cold. I can feel her temperature. But look at how small her head and a gorgeous bigger body is. So she's been eating so well. And we'll send her back so she can eat some more. Beauty. Wow, she went right down, right back down to the bottom.
Lure selection for doing this kind of fishing is pretty simple. All we're trying to replicate is just a minnow. This is a 4¾-inch freeloader. This is one of the new Crush Cities. Pretty much we're just finding minnow baits that hang horizontal in the water. This is an interesting one because with the freeloader, it's weighted nose forwards. It's actually a PVC bait, so it sinks. But with the weight forward design, it puts the weight to the head of the bait, and it still hangs horizontal just because of how it kind of balances on the head. A lot of the weight's right near the line tie. So it hangs perfectly horizontal. And then another option is the jerk. I like this one. It's also a little bit smaller. Maybe if the lake you're fishing is a little bit more smelt dominant, smaller fish, smaller bait fish, you can run a, this is a 3 3/4 inch minnow bait. And this is the super teepee, the really stretchy stuff. And when you rig this on a head, it's buoyant, so it floats the back up. And that's kind of a traditional moping technique. But these are the two baits that I kind of run. I really don't stray away from whites. As long as you're mimicking a bait fish, white pretty much does it. Any variant of white, this is kind of white and gray with a little blue reflection on the top, and this is white with some kind of green flake. But this is what I'm running, just imitating minnows. So far, so good. I mean, if you look at this, it's been getting chewed. The other little tip to position your boat properly in the wind is to always have your back facing the wind. Even if you're going forwards, even if you're going backwards, if you have your back towards the wind, if you're in reverse, you can pop it into neutral and then back troll. And if you're in forwards and you mark a fish, you pop it into reverse and you hang over. It's better than going nose into the wind, and it's also better than just always running into the wind or crosswind. If you can try to position yourself, oh, there's that fish again.
Oh my gosh, look how fast he's coming. Good boy.
No. There he is. He's here, mind grabbing the net?
Yeah.
Nice laker.
Beauty.
They're nice little fish. We've got some nice ones here before, but we're just yo-yoing them. They'll come running up, and we're using 2D. We have the live running, but we're not really using it. We're using two-dimensional sonar, boating around until we mark them, and then you just play around with them. Try and get them to run if they don't want to run, and you can drop it a bit, and you just, the main focus is just getting them to chase. If they're chasing and running, they'll smack it. Beauty little fish. In order to do this kind of fishing, you're not trolling and you're not jigging specific structure. You're looking for individual fish. The whole point of this is to search around. You can do it pretty quick, 2-3 mile an hour. You gotta play the wind so you can control your boat properly in these situations. Locate the fish, try to keep it on the sonar, and then drop your bait down, and then you just play them. You learn their attitude, you learn what they like, you can gauge their mood, and then once you kind of put all those pieces together, you'll start catching a bunch of lake trout, and it's one of my favorite ways to do it. It's a great way to catch lake trout. You're really mobile, it's fast fishing, fast pace, and it works really well. So give it a shot, and if you guys haven't done it before, play around. I think it'll be something new that you can put in the arsenal of techniques for lake trout, and yeah, it's a ton of fun.